start. So the materials of the election, the term of the election is how to go to Russia and open the, your own business if you have some idea, some business idea. So Russia is not so dangerous country as it seems to some people. So have you been in Russia? Some, yes, a lot of us have been in Russia. You believe that it's not so dangerous country, it's a normal country. I can say that it's towns like Moscow, St. Petersburg, and Ekaterinburg and other countries, other towns are very modern countries, very modern towns, and they have a good infrastructure for business. They have, let's say, at the papers formality, they have very good laws for doing business. Of course, Russia is a country where it's different between formal laws and life laws are different, so we'll talk about this today. So you know that investment attractiveness in Russia is very high, that's why a lot of people from West countries go to Russia to make money. Because it's true that in Russia return of investments is very high. But from other side, the risk is too high as well. So it's always question if you go back to bank to put your money for 1% and you have care about you have stable 1% in Russia, you can put money to bank and you will get 10% or 100%, but you have the 100% risk. So this is the difference. Anyway, we will talk today about legislation accompanying with foreign owner in Russia, forms of incorporations, types, pros and cons, taxation, duty and excise, labor relations, including immigration law. So it's a very important question in Russia, immigration law and labor relations between general director and other and staff. So next point will be bankruptcy, closing down the company, allowances, permissions, need, procedures to occur, and a little bit talk about the accounting system in Russia and banking system. So as in Russia is very strong laws about business and about migration, so it's very important to open company with all procedures that are needed by the Russian law. So otherwise you will meet a lot of authorities who will come to you and let's say easy to ask money from you. The main laws which you have to know in order to establish an operation of organization in Russia is a civil code, Companies Act, it's like commercial codex in other words. So the law on limited liability companies and on state registration of legal entities individual. So civil code is regulated a lot of commercial and business relationship in terms of houses, so in terms of property of companies and other things. in Estonia, for example, it's very easy to open company. You can do it through internet, and you don't need to fill a lot of documents, and it can take 5-10 minutes for internet. So in Russia, it's very difficult to open company in order to, in terms of, you have to fill up a lot of statements, documents, and first recommendation I can give you to, if you want to open company in Russia, so you don't have to do it by yourself. Try to do it with law companies who suggested the service in each corner in big cities. But as in another life, you can choose this company, choose this company from your friends, from people who you know. So a lot of deals and business and relationship in Russia are stated on terms of good friendship, or you must know people with whom you're working. So, in order to register a company with foreign capital in Russia, it is necessary to carry out the whole range of the legal actions that you want to implement Russian citizen in the registration of the entities without foreign participation. To register a company with foreign capital, must provide an expanded list of documents compared with the package of documents necessary for registration of organization with Russian capital. Consider the example of package document of registration of a limited liability company. So as you see, the cost of this company is for 100 euro. You have to make a paper decision of establishing of founders. So it's like minotaur for founders. It can be two people or one people, it doesn't matter, three people. Then you have to write the charter company. What I say, it's very difficult to, if you're not lawyer, to write this document. But this document, it's very important in Russia because it's strange, but you have to make a lot of copies of this document, and in each department, in each authorities where you go, so they ask from you this copy of this document, and more I can say that it should be authorized by notary. In this document, one nuance, it's stated general manager of the company, rights of general manager of the company. And in this document, all rights and all obligations of the general director of the company are stated. And we will talk about the general director later. So. All documents in Russia must be translated to Russian and should be authorized by a local notary. So it's very strange, but sometimes they ask even it's called apostille. Next. Point important in Russia is you could not register the company without a juridical address. And to confirm that you have juridical address, you have to sign, let's say, rent document for rent, for example, flat or office or otherwise other things. So it's strange, but you should have the place where you will work, and sometimes tax department can come to us, come to you, to office, and see if it's the table, if it's computer or something like that. Because if it's a fiction letter, so you can be punished. So we'll talk about this later too. So it's for individual, it's not so big range of documents. If you want to establish company with another companies, so you have to fill and give to authorities this range of documents. So maybe I will not read the papers, and if you have questions about points about this in this, so I can maybe explain more detailed what is this. But I think the documents that I showed here is usual and understandable. Anyway, the above documents is not complete, since the registration of companies with 100% foreign ownership and equity participation, there's some difference. Other than the content, the package document depends on the list of founders of the legal entity. So,
excuse me, I have a question. How easy it is to open a bank account in
From one side, it's very easy for if you decide to establish company. But when you go to bank, they ask you a lot of papers, and all most of the papers is these papers. So if you have registered company, and you have all documents, you'll bring with you all these documents, and they will open your account for you about 2-5 days. It's not a problem to open, it's a problem to have all papers.
And I could ask, for example, if I have a personal account in Russia and I plan just to remove it, for example, I have a company and I would like this account just for my company, not for myself. Is it easy?
Yes, I said that if you have company, you have no problem to open the account in a bank.
So it's not a problem? I think, well, it's not a problem in Russia just to receive a bank account if you are, otherwise if you have a company or personal, it's not difficult.
Personal, it's difficult if personal account, but if you have company and to open company account, it's not problem if you have all documents and all paper that you have company and you are a responsible person for opening account and other things. So maybe I didn't get the question.
But just for established company, we need to provide officials with bank account. And how we could provide them with bank account for established company?
Okay, I understand.
So it's like a
so the procedure is that you have to sign this. Memorandum, charter company memorandum and articles. Yes, with this you go to tax department. Then then you state that you want to open company. They registered your state. They give you paper that you have registered, and with this paper you go to bank.
Mm-hmm.
And then they open your account, and then you go back to confirm that you have account, and it will be called temporary account. So on this account you have to put this share capital, and then after all the procedures are closed, you can use this account. Understand? So I get questions, thank you. Yes, and we'll more details about general director of company. So if foreign company or foreign people want to establish company in Russia, they have to know a very important thing. That head of the company can be only general director. And general director can be only citizen of Russia. This is the point that you have to know. And it's very difficult to manage with company from start. If you have, willing to open company with your partner from Russia, it's okay. There are also the nuances that you should to believe to this guy very good, very well, because general director of the company have absolutely rights to sell company, to sell property, to sell all that company belong. And you, even if you are owner, you can do nothing with this. It's nuance you have to know. And there is another point of delaying procedure, because if you want to be personally the general director, you have to obtain a permit for work in Russia. This procedure can take about 3-6 months. And we will talk about this procedure more detailed, but it's some conflict. And 100% if you have not your friends in Russia, it's very difficult to start your own business with your own responsibility without any dangers.
What is the reality, in fact, about the general managers? Are they fictional general managers then, or are they the Russian citizens who actually run them?
So always it depends. If you want to do your own business and it's real business, it's real work. Of course, and if you have managed and if you trust to your partner, so you can. You can put him as a general manager until you have this permission work. So, if you own, it's problem. In Russia, a lot of companies have fixed, as you said, fictional general manager, because a lot of small companies they are. One day company, I said. But in real business, general manager is real manager. And next important person in the management company is chief accountant. It's very often it's also right in this charter and memorandum, because. It's connection with the bank system. In bank system, you have to, unfortunately, most of the bank activity in Russia is at paper. So if you want to, of course, they have telebank and other things. But if you have, if you want to make payment with, let's say, with confirmation, you have to go to bank and sign this paper, confirmation papers by yourself, and they compare your signatures, and there's a lot of curious cases with this. For example, my signature is changed from my mood, and I want to do one signature with another day another signature, and a lot of times accountants girls come back from bank and said it's not your signature, bank did not accept it. So it's as well this account of the signature in this papers state. And if you want to establish a company and maybe you can put yourself to the documents as a general director, it can go through, but if someone will check it, inspect it, you have to, you will have a big problem with immigration laws. So, for different organizations, form of companies have different terms of payment of the authorized capital. Companies, small company, 50% of share capital should be paid up to date registration of the company. For public joint stock company, it should be paid 50% of share capital and later, not later than 3 months from the date of registration company. Other 50% you can pay during 1 year. Also, you can pay not only by cash, you can put some investments, property or materials or assets of the founders. So, and as I said, the payment of the authorized capital up to the moment of state registration of the company, what I said, yes, by opening a temporary bank account from which you made after registration of the founders or the money is transferred to the main account of the company. If you want to put your share capital with the state, so it's you will do by transferring the property to the head of the company under the act temporary, and after checking company founders made by the head of the property is transferred by in act to the company. So understand that first you will transfer by act, for example, computer will transfer to the act to the general manager of the company, and then general manager will and transfer it to the company by act. And of course, if you open a big company or would like to its big share capital and you put your house or something, maybe assets, so it should be supplied with confirmation of authority who said that it's cost such money that you stated, that you mentioned. The law does not require documentary evidence of the location of the enterprise, exact addresses and the territory of Russia in his account. But later on, in the course of business, the company will need to have the document on the basis of which its registration is made at specific address specified in the statute. That I say that all companies have to have the other address where people from authorities can come and see what's going on. Such document can be a certificate of ownership of any non-resident premises, lease office or non-resident premises, usually with a copy of the certificate of ownership of the lessor's premises. So yes, you can. You have to show this owner. If you lease in the office, you can. You must show the owner's certificate of ownership. In St. Petersburg and Leningrad region, it's one thing interesting that you can, if you have permission to live in, if you are a foreign resident but you have a temporary or continuous permit of living in Russia and you have your own address where you live, you can use this address for registration of the company. But it's only in St. Petersburg and Leningrad region. The tax authorities have to write to inspect the actual location of the company at the address specified in statute. If in the absence of registration of the company you could be fined fined in the amount of 5,000 rubles, is 120 euro. Most often, the fact of being the company's registered address is checked by banks, custom authority, and leasing companies. However, a recent increase in the address verification by security service of major Russian companies with state participation. The question is that a lot of Russia, businesses, big businesses going by tenders. So all companies, especially all big companies, holdings like Gazprom, Lukoil, or Metal Invest, they, in order to supply their companies with goods, with materials, with equipment, they making tenders. All state company, 100%, they buy their needs or goods for their needs only by the tender. And it's some kind of business in Russia that a lot of people opened their own company. For example, one guy sitting at his flat and playing in these tenders every day. So they have information about buyers and they, from tender they about suppliers from tender they tried to they know about information about buyers and main business to connect these two sides. But if tender is millions euro, so safety department of that big companies, they started to check who is participating. And if company suggests stuff for millions euro and have not any property and sitting in small room, so it's understand that this company is not not able to supply with goods. For major tenders for the supply of goods or services for the implementation of large companies, such checks can be carried out in secret. Any commercial organization in Russia may charge in any activity that is not prohibited by the law. On the individual activities required to obtain license, for example, passenger transport, trade in alcohol, mining, educational activities. Main activities of the company are declared at check-in and specified the unified state register of legal entities. Moreover, this concept of core business, the main purpose to determine the amount of the premium social security of workers. In the future you can change as many times as the main activity. It's understand that when you stated when you registered company, you have to write in the memorandum that kind of business with which you will deal. But life is life, and tomorrow you will decide to make a new direction of your business in other activity. In this case, you have to go to authorities and register your new activity, and its connection. Its connections with change your memorandum. So it's again, it's money, it's time, it's formalities. So good memorandum is memorandum with 100 activities that you wish will do. each activity is indicated by the statistical software. Full list of status in the classified national classification of economic activities. So when you start business, you will see this document and choose all activities that you will do, and you have to put it to the memorandum. So one interesting thing in Russia that every commercial organization in Russia have to have their own round seal. Sometimes they call it wet seals. I'm sorry, I'm worrying about it a little. So wet seal, what is it say that the original stamp was put it on the paper. It's very strange, but you can order the seal in streets at small companies, and it's cost about 200 rubles what you want. But seal is very important. Each document must be provided with the seal. Seal is not registered anywhere. Manufacturer seals deal with a lot of companies enough to express your wishes, and you manufacture any seals. A reprint round seal is required at the bank and the custom authorities. The company also has the right to have an unlimited amount of any stamps and use them on your own. However, all the basic documents of the company must be certified by a round wet seal. For example, the notary does not notarize document without the round seal. Next point. It's theoretical figures, but in practice, from date of you wish to start the company and you went to authorities, and first will be the tax department, it will take 2 months. So if you will ask about this lawyer company, they will do it for 1 month, and the price will be depends on the company, but not less than 200-300 euro. So you can spend money and not spend the time. Yeah, so this 500 euro companies, which law companies mainly, which deal with company establishment for you, they at this time at this time suggest you juridical address. It will be cost 500 euro for 1 year, 500 euro for 1 year. And, but it's not so good because you never know where this address is situated. Is it legal, or is it house, or is it village? You never know what they will suggest to you. And if authorities or tax policemen will come to this address and find nothing, so you will have problems. So talk shortly about the establishing company and its form. But you have to know sometimes people want to open branch office. It's necessary to distinguish the creation of companies with foreign investments from the opening of a branch office accreditation of a foreign legal entity in Russia. The branch is a separate subdivision of a foreign legal entity located outside of its location and performing all or part of the functions, including the function of representation. Registration is done by a branch of its accreditation in the manner determined by government of the Russian Federation. The branch is considered to be accredited in the information on the list listed on the state register of branches of foreign legal entities. What's the difference? So it's branches are not full responsible company in the territory of Russia. When you open the branch, you have not any obligations before your clients. All obligations belong to your mother company or your parent company or foreign company which establish this branch in Russia. That's why they look for branches very carefully. It's very difficult to open branch because this accreditation is very long and big process. Easy to open your own company with full responsibility, and you can full manage with your company. Branch and it's opened mainly political organization, non-commercial organizations, and funds. Even big company like Coca-Cola, Siemens, ABB, they open it in Russia, the company with full documents and other things. But anyway, if you want to open branch, you have to make these things. Stages of registration of the company with foreign capital. Founders are holding a meeting of the founders, develop bylaws, sign the necessary documents. The head of the notary signs the application for registration of the company. The founders issues the power of attorney to representative of conducting supply and deliver all documents to the tax office. Federal Tax Services carries out the state registration of the legal entity carried out simultaneously with the registration of tax registration, obtaining codes of state statistics committee, registration with the pension fund, the social insurance fund, and the fund of obligatory medical insurance. The representative of the founders of the company received the documents after registration. The head of the company or a representative of the proxy opens a bank account. After committing of all of this activity, the company is registered business entity and may work legally. There are features and limitations of participation of foreign investment in Russian companies. Such features are set for the banking and insurance activities in these areas. The state provides certain restrictions for foreign investors. There is also a restriction on the purchase of shares by foreign investors and the largest Russian companies with state capitals like Gazprom, Rosneft and others. In fact, it's only main activities, but a lot of activities you have to make a license, so you have to obtain special permissions. And if you want to go to Russia for business, you have to very carefully study these things. Even if you put in state or memorandum activity and started to do business without special permission or license, you will have a problem. So we'll now more detailed talking about forms and rules, which company and which legal form better to establish. First, easiest way to start business in Russia is individual entrepreneur. But again, exceptions. If you want to be individual entrepreneur, you have to be a citizen of Russia. So the best way and the most optimal way to establish limited liability company, it's most popular form in Russia. It's maybe in Estonia it's very similar with also closed joint stock company. It's like in Estonia, maybe access it, share unit. So if business is easy, you don't like to put a lot of money as a share capital, you, for example, try to open shop or small plant, better to open this limited liability company. Each of these forms has advantages and disadvantages. Selection of a particular form of incorporation of the enterprise depends on many different factors. The set and the effect of these factors are different for different types of business. For example, before the start of the business, you have to some questions. Do you like independence? Do you want to start a business with someone else? Are you willing to provide a large documentation in the company? Are you going to buy large quantities of goods on credit? Are you able to independently make the required amount of capital? As it's often the case, you may find that your answer suggests several possible solutions. You will also eventually will have to choose the best form of incorporation of your company. The answers to the above questions may lead to the following conclusions. You have decided to conduct a joint business activities. Do you want to start a business with someone else? Then you should think about the closed joint stock company or a limited liability company. Your sales activity is associated with a greater risk. It may be wise to think about a closed joint stock company. If you cause difficulty in maintaining the register of shareholders and additional reporting on the shares, you should choose a limited liability company. You are going to buy large quantities of goods on credit, then it is better to choose a closed joint company. Some of the findings may seem contradictory. At the same time, the final selection of the optimal variant is yours. It is necessary to analyze all the pros and cons. But I will see anyway about a private entrepreneur, because maybe you'll start business with your Russian friend or partner and start with this form. Private entrepreneur is a natural person who is engaged in business activity independently. Private entrepreneur can only be a citizen of Russia, so in the context of this lecture, the floor of business is irrelevant. However, some consider this form. Advantages: a minimum of organization formality, a minimum of accounting documents, economic independence. There is no need to make share capital. The main disadvantage of a private entrepreneur is that it is labeled for its obligation with all its assets. So if you have your own flat and something happens with your business, authorities will take off your flat. Serious problem can arise from a private owner on the event of his illnesses or absence from. It is not pressing, the issue may be in trouble. Now let's talk about limited liability company. Many companies, most of them use this particular form of incorporation. Limited liability company is a grouping of physical and or legal entities for joint economic activities. The authorized capital is formed only through the contribution of the founders. The minimum capital of 10,000 rubles. Limited liability company is a legal entity and has its own name. All members of limited liability company is a liable for its obligation with their deposits. Distinguishes the form of incorporation of a private entrepreneur, and a private entrepreneur shall be liable for its obligation with all its assets. The main advantage of a limited liability company is that the solvency of each participant in the company obligation is limited to the amount of contributed by them to the authorized capital in accordance with the contract. This is significant in that case if you are going to take a large amount of money on credit or large number of goods to market, or is planning to implementation any risk business transactions. Limited liability company continues to exist even if some of the participants decided to withdraw from or died. This does not affect the state of society as a whole. Another advantage is that your children can participate in a given society is inherited. But this form has some shortcomings. Any deal for the transition of ownership of share capital must be notarized. Significantly increases the time for the issue a large number of accounting documents. Every time you have to disclose the detail of the business, presenting to the authorities the necessary financial documentation. All founders of agreement to make a total of half of share capital at the time of registration. Have any question about this? Because it's maybe easy to me to answer the questions. So I can read, of course. Okay. How to register a limited liability company? They can be done in three ways. You can register a limited liability company on their own. You can contact the law firm which is engaged in business registration and setting out their demands, they can issue a limited level company. You can buy already made limited level company. And third variant, I can say it's I'm not recommended. It's very big risk because the market of let's say second-hand companies is very big. And very often these companies are not clear. So it's one of the business, one of the black business to sell and buy companies with history. On this company you buy for example, for 40,000, for 20,000 rubles, you can get debts for millions. And at the one moment, people will come to you and ask where the money. But the problem is that to check this company is very difficult. If you are first time in Russia and nobody know in Russia, and you go to the law office and they suggest, why do you want to wait? Well, here's a company, buy it. They show you documents, it's okay. But after 2 weeks or 1 month, you will open that this company is very dirty. So, in our case, if we are starting from here or from other countries and don't know Russian well, best here to choose a law company. It can be done by internet and sign the contract, and you have to come to Russia 2 times, first time to sign documents with notary, and next time to come to Russia and get all needed documents to your hand. Self-registration, your cost will include state fee for registration of a company in the tax office, 4,000 rubles. Payment notary's signature on the application for registration of the company, 1,000 rubles. If you go to a law firm, your cost will be about 3 times as much, but the time for the prepare registration of the enterprise significantly reduced. If you buy a ready-made company, the cost will be about the same. Registration will take about a bit of time, in which case you get someone else's articles of association, someone else's name, and so on. And if you later want to change something, it will require additional costs. It's a practical problem, official problem, that you have to change some activities in the memorandum. But life show that it's not recommended by the words I said. According to statistics, the majority of Russian enterprises prefer to conduct business registration through specialized law firms, companies. It is most likely due to the complexity of filling special form for registration of the company. Yes, this is very important thing. It's Russia. So, from one side, you can find in internet all the required documents and filling forms. You'll fill it by your own and by your mind of what you do think. And then you will come to this authority, they sit in a nice woman and say, okay, here's, you did mistake. So please come next time. When next time? Next time will be 3 weeks. So it's okay. So you come next time. She read a second list of your papers and say, here's a mistake. Here's a I don't like. So it's maybe a real mistake. It's maybe a formal mistake. It's maybe something like that. But anyway, purpose of this to make money for the lawyers' companies, because 99% these people who sit in offices, in state offices, in these authorities, in tax department, they are very connected with lawyers' company. And sometimes and very often, after first or second coming to this authority, this nice woman will say, okay, guy, I see you are very in trouble, so I can give you a telephone number, you can call to this office, and all will be okay. It's manner. Before you expand business operations and begin to fill in the relevant financial documents, consult an accountant who can give you good advice about the establishment of the accounting profession in your enterprise. This is a no small matter, as the director is responsible for the state of accounting at the enterprise. The limited liability company has been operated under a statute. So about accounting. Accountant is a very important person. Why? First point. We will talk it later more detail, but further I would say that tax laws and accounting laws in Russia are very, very, very hard. Every day, chief accountant get by email or by post new documents from authorities, from tax department, from ministry. That okay, we have new instructions. So that point in that law number paragraph the same. It's changed, and now its reduction is the same. Is it new? And it's a lot of information every day. Second point, you have to fill, your accounting department have to fill a lot of papers, hundreds, I will show you further. Hundreds papers can fill by hand, and each paper must be sent to departments. And next point, that accounting is very, very important department in your business, is that want you or not want, you have to have black money in your company. And very often you have two accountants, yes? So you have one official accountant and one black accountant. And this information belongs to your chief accountant. A lot of times I heard cases and participate once that when your chief accountant said you bye-bye, so you will have a big problem and court will be most solve this problem. Because chief accountant know a lot of information, especially about your black money, about your black deals, and about other things. It should be, you must be very careful with person who you whom you invite to this position. And all accountants and all people who are dealing with accountant, they know these problems. First, when they come to you to the interview, they ask a lot of money. And when you ask what you think about tax deduction or other things, I have experience in things in now. So. More detailed, we will talk about statute, what it should be included. The statute includes the name and type of society, the object and purpose of economic activity, size of the authorized capital, provision of limited liability, management structure and governance, order of reorganization and liquidation, and so on. The statute must contain all the main features of type of society, the object and purpose of its activities, the founders, name and location, size of the authorized capital, economic activities, procedures for calling and conducting meeting, rights and duties of the director. That I say that in the statute it's very important from the first moment, from the first moment of the company, to sign very carefully the rights and duties of the director. Because from other side, you have to give him all rights, because he you represented you in banks, he conclusion commercial contracts, he buys and sell products and other things. It's not, you can divide this, you can limit this operation. But from other side, he could sell your company, and it's very important to write and duties of the directors, rights and duties. Change the order of the director and his terms of office, rights and obligation of the company. Describes how the financial control and the dividend is declared, the procedure of the payment. Description of liquidation and reorganization. Orders of the creditors and the liquidation of the budget and so on. Now is the time to say a few words about a third of the form of incorporation of the company, closed joint stock company. It's very similar to liability company, but there's presented some important things. The form of incorporation of the enterprise is a whole similar to the limited liability company. However, there are some differences. Closed joint stock company is established as a limited liability company, one of several founders, but only the corporation has the right to issue shares, and these shares in the closed joint stock company are distributed among its founders. So the difference is that you cannot sell share out of the company, other people who are not participating in the company. Even if no, your partners don't want these shares. The number of shareholders in the closed joint stock company shall not be more than 50, or to carry out the transformation into a public company. So if you have 51, you have to reorganize to a public company. The founders of the agreement is signed on the establishment, on the moment when established, which expires after the private limited liability company and run by the founders of all the responsibilities to create it. In all official documents before the name of the enterprise should present the abbreviation ZAO. Responsibility as well as for limited liability company to the value of the shares of participants. The minimum capital is 10,000 rubles. But I can say that I did not see it in practice. It's no sense to have share capital 10,000 rubles if you open the closed joint stock company, because it's like, I think, in the whole world. If you want to play with serious business and your partners will be see your share capital, your name and your form of enterprise. And I think in real it started from 1 million rubles, maybe more. And self-registration cost will include all the money that we stated previous, but here's one more. State duty for registration of the shares in the Federal Service for Financial Markets. So it's a very strict obligation to register all shareholders in Federal Service for Financial Markets. And you have to do it during 1 month, and you will get back papers after they will make all things about 2 months. So 3 months take this procedure. A key advantage and different from the limited liability company is that to sell, give away the shares without shareholder main authorization of transaction. It's from one side in Russia all deals are, you cannot translate your passport without notarius, but you can sell shares without notarius in this closed joint stock company. It's very strange point, and the register of the shareholders where the company may carry of their own. Transfer of title or to the share makes the head of the company. Another key advantage is that the shares are transferred to the shareholder in the trust, which always you do not disclose information about the owner of business. Otherwise, the closure of the company is very similar to a limited company. And at present time in Russia, there is a big law discussion about the elimination of such organization form as a closed joint stock company. Just for reason, it is assumed that there will only be a public joint stock company. So, a lot of people from government in Russia, they have ownership in liability companies. And maybe you heard about this new laws that if you government people, you don't have permission to make business and have a business. And they use this limited liability company in order to give their share to the trust. In this way, if you give share by the Russian law, nobody can know who is owner of these shares. The disadvantages of this organization form. Any deal for the transition of ownership of shares, sale, donation, and so on, not be notarized, which may provide an opportunity for fraud. Requires registration of the shares in the Federal Service for Financial Markets. Apply for registration of shares needed for 1 month from the date of registration, and the registration deadline is 2 months. Significantly increase the amount of reporting of the shares of the Federal Service for Financial Markets. Next point is company name. Having determined the optimal organization form of incorporation, should seriously consider the choice of company name. You can safely use your name or the names of the partners. It is desirable that the name of your company is not repeated the names of existing businesses. But during registration, tax authorities cannot refuse because of the consideration of the name of with other companies. It's a big problem in Russia, very big problem. You can find hundreds and thousands of companies with the same name. And if you open, try to find company with name, let's see, Solnushka, Sun, and you'll find a lot of companies. And if you don't know with what dealing this company, it's very difficult to recognize it. And I think it's also the window for not honest people. because sometimes companies with the same name, they are playing at the one field of the market. So you have to think over about a very original name when you establish business in Russia. And this this problem is in the field of copyright protection, because nobody can defend the name glasses, for example. So you must use the official company name in official correspondence, invoices, receipt, invoices, and so on. You must specify in this document abbreviation of the legal form of the company, ZAO or OOO. Official corporate name, the location, address of the organization. Try wherever possible to use them to advertise your business. It should be noted that there are some items that cannot be used without permission. For example, the words bank, Bank of Russia, Russia, Moscow, insurance, and a lot of other words. For the use of proper names of the cities, countries, and so on, in the name of a company, it will be charged an additional fee. In addition, the user of the emblem of the country, the republic, the city, also requires a special permit and payment. In conclusion, let's compare some of the main parameters considered of the chapter of forms of incorporation of companies. So, private entrepreneur, there can be only be a citizen of Russia. The responsibility for liabilities is all its assets. Accounting procedure for an individual entrepreneur is easier. Income and expenditure and business transactions conducted by individual entrepreneurs by fixing the book of income and expenditure or business transactions. So one book, all transactions. Taxes. Taxation depends on the tax system. There are some pro and contras for the both. For individual entrepreneur, there is easy tax system if they have volume about 100,000 rubles per year. They pay only 6%. And that's all. 6,000 rubles they pay each year, and no other taxes. Discontinued operations, order determination of an individual entrepreneur is much easier to order liquidation or legal entitlements, and most better is that registration deadline in tax office is 5 working days. Limited liability company. The responsibility for liabilities, limitation of liability. You only lose the capital contribution. This way, people who are not honest in business, they use this liability company. They very often they buy goods from for commission trading. They buy goods from whole companies. Buy, then not pay, then closed. And when you come to this company or start this bankrupt process, you can see that they have 10,000 rubles and nothing more. And rented office, and they don't answer by their own property, or own. Um, Accountant requires conducting official accounting and reporting in accordance with the formal requirements. That I will say that a lot of documents. The company maintains records in accordance with the requirements of the federal law on accounting. Individual entrepreneur is not. Taxation depends on the tax system. There are some pro and contras. This continued operation, orders of liquidation, or a long and laborious. Preparation of reports, enough time consuming procedure. The authorized capital. The authorized capital of the economy shall not be less than 10,000 rubles. Any deal for the transition of ownership of the share capital, sale, donation, and so on, must be notarized. Registration deadline in the tax office is 5 working days. The responsibility for liabilities, close the joint stock company. The responsibility for liabilities to the extent of the value of its shares. Accountant requires conducting official accounting and reporting in accordance with the formal requirements. The company maintains records in accordance with the requirements of the federal law on accounting. Other things are the same that I mentioned. One difference, the required state registration of the shares in the Federal Service for Financial Markets. So, in this part of the lecture was briefly considered some of the most popular to date forms of incorporation for companies in Russia. Then, in second part of this lecture, we'll provide a brief overview of other existing Russian legal forms and companies. So, if honest, it's all about forms of business, and maybe you have any. So we have time, and maybe I will answer a question about how it in practice, and maybe you have some ideas about, and I can answer how to do it better.